Is it on? Check, yeah.
Okay.
All right.
Good. So we're ready.
This, I'll give this to you the next lesson.
Yeah, okay.
When she gets on. Is that okay?
Yeah, this. Yeah. Oh, good. You just take your time with pretty relaxed legs. Good. And I feel your neck is good, yeah. You feel, well, she's pretty low, but not drop your neck. Good. I push a little forward, yeah. So you just, yeah. So you make a little difference when you touch your horse and then relax your legs and touch a little again. So every time you touch a little for your legs, you feel also your horse change the tempo. Right. Oh, good. So it's from your forward, she likes to coming out and down to the bridle. She looks pretty fine here from the beginning. Good. All right. So you just push a little forward again. So you feel when you are pushing, your horse not get first up in your neck and then going, but stay down, stretching down into your hand. It's a good beginning. Good. And now you sink on your legs to make your heels really low. To come down there. Yep. Oh, pretty good. Try to come on all your arena and come with 17 loops. Or you just gonna keep your same tempo. So you stay in front of your legs. Good. Right. Okay, good. So just start, you know, with 17 loops and turns. So you work on your shoulders, because I said your tempo and your neck is fine. Then you work on to control your shoulders and get balance. And the inside leg, yeah? Good. You feel if she get a little tight, you move your fingers. All right. So when she likes to come down, then you also work on, she get a little softer in your bending, but not losing outside shoulder. So you still have this balance in her. Pretty good. Just forward, yeah. Good. So just come on all your rein again where you go back to make these loops. All right. So you feel it's for your legs, also you change your bending. So just turn again. These 17 loops is what make your horse ready, I've said, for all your exercise. All your exercise where you need bending. So make your turn a little bigger from inside leg. Good, and forward, yeah. Oh, pretty good, yeah. Right. Hold it, just go long side. And then try to change with a little shoulder in, straight, shoulder in, straight. So make a little difference. Good. Try to go straight again. A little outside half hold. So and bend a little outside, outside leg. Good. Okay. And then shoulder in again. You feel, yeah, so you work a little on both sides. Good. Try to go straight again. And then bend a little outside way angle. Right. So you push her a little into a turn from outside side. Just a little outside again. Yep. Okay. And try to make a little leg gilding, yeah. Good. And turn, yeah. So she follow you. Good. All right. You feel on your knees weight, just work on your shoulders. So next time you just go long side again, we'll come with a little shoulder in again. Oh, good. So have a little bending from your corner. Good. Yep. And still a little to outside rein. So you get very elastic inside side. Good. So just do the same again. All right. So you're bending first shoulder in, Right. Good. And then a little toe straight and outside side. So bending a little more outside and angle for outside leg. Not good. Yep, outside leg. Yep. Good. And just go to walk. It's pretty good here. I'm really pretty pleased today here, how she's starting up. And what you're doing here, it's the same plan in your training you have with all horses. These basic things where you feel your horse are moving in a tempo you want, where it's easy to go more forward if you want. You feel your neck get down, round, but it's up to you how low. If you can get your horse easy lower, you don't need it. So you just keep, you have a good balance in your neck compared to your back, and then you start to work on your shoulders. Because with all horses we talk about, you know, there's a little difference. And yes, you just keep work both sides, you know, a little shoulder in, a little outside, so it gets easy to push your horse around. And then there is 17 loops also you have in your normal training every day with all horses. Yeah. I said, I start with this when your horse are ready from their young, already perhaps as 4, at least 5 years. Mm-hmm. So I start these loops and turns to get your horse in balance. So it's the same, you know, system I use with all horses. Okay. So it's not get too complicated. Yeah. So I feel we need to take some little candor.
Okay. Maybe do the right side
first? Doesn't matter, you need both. And yeah, to get a nice candor transition, okay, you come from walk, you could bend a little outside, a little inside, so you also get soft outside shoulder. If you get too busy in your walk, you make some small turns, like you was doing yesterday also. So you get your neck a little more down. Yep. All right. Good. And it's okay, take your time for a little more trot work. So get your neck down also here with a sitting trot. Yep. Good. So you soften up inside side. Try, yep, using a little more inside leg. Yep, that was fine. And then to your opposite side. So you also feel you can make like shoulder in on your circle. Try to keep your inside leg more back. Okay. And then the opposite, yeah. Inside leg a little back. So yeah, good. And make your circle a little smaller again. Right. You feel that your horse have a lot of power, but it is to soften more up here in your bending. Try to change the rein again. Yep. And inside leg. Inside. You feel when your turn gets so small, you also go after more bending. And you feel now she needs to be a little lower in your neck. So you get a little more up in your back so he get nicer to sit on. Yep. Good. All right. Try to, yep, and come a little shoulder in on your circle again. Get inside leg a little back. Right. And control outside shoulder. Yes, enough. Good. And then change the rein again. So you work on, you can get the same to right. So make a little angle here, so he cross his hind legs. Right. And just keep turning. Okay, good. I feel you just let him go to canter and start to warm more up in your canter. It's okay, good. And your tempo is fine, yeah. And then you do the same change, you're bending a little. Yep, and give a little again, good. So get elastic inside. Right. Okay. And then come to the long side here, you're bending a little outside to get outside shoulder. So soften your inside hand. Try to go, yep, a little more outside. Good. So go on the long side and make some small circles. Like we were doing yesterday, where you feel you get your outside shoulder, a soft inside hand, outside. Outside, keep going. Yeah, it's okay. Just keep going. Good, take your times, yeah. Good. And canter. Okay. Try to go on the long side where you make outside bending and also outside angle. Yep. And when you start your circles, you just make them bigger. A little outside. Yep. And then you're bending a little outside. Outside leg. Good. And try to keep him in the circle. It's okay to make a circle really big. Get outside side. And outside. Outside, outside leg. And then bend outside just when you have your track. Good. So just do the same again. So you don't make your circle smaller before you control your outside shoulder more. Good. Just circle again. And bend the outside leg. Yep. Forward. 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 Good. And get outside side. Good. And bend outside. It's just to keep train yet every time you're riding him. So you will control the side of your circle from control your shoulder. All right. You feel so you're not as turning from inside rein, but from pushing into your turn. Pretty good. Or trot again. Good. And try to make a transition to canter again from trot. You feel so you bring him a little back and then ask for canter again. Half hold, half hold, half hold, slowly. I said close to walk but stay in trot. Yeah, and canter from there. Good. So even if it was a little high in your neck, but you have to feel you control your tempo. Yep. Good. And try trot again for outside half hold. Outside. Good. Oh, good. So you can feel he's just relaxed and waiting. So now just do the same in left canter. For inside leg, yeah. Okay, he's okay.
The owner wants to ride a little bit too.
Yeah, yes, I know, yeah.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're not
jumping
in here.
On a bit.
Okay, be ready. We just need a little left canter.
Yeah, we don't want to make him too tired since he's not super fit, so.
But he looks really pretty.
I know,
forward.
And it's fun to work. I know.
Yeah, and he looks pretty. I should take just a left canter one time. Yeah.
I'm not saving you, Amanda. You keep going.
No, yeah. No, but your horse looks. He looks pretty forward today.
Good. Yeah. He's fit, huh?
Yeah. He looks tired or anything.
Good.
He'll be fine.
Okay, we'll be fine. Huh?
Yeah.
Good.
No, I have not forgot it.
Okay, good. So, I know. Fun, I know.
Yep.
It's fun to work with her too. Huh?
She's really good.
Yeah, I know. Don't you love? I know.
And she has good feeling.
Yes.
And she can improve in her position with her legs most.
Yeah.
Because she has a jump rider's legs.
Yes, out. Yep. Yeah.
And she has a pretty good seat.
I think so too.
And
she wants to so bad.
Right.
Yeah. She really wants this.
No, that's good.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. Yeah. You just go walk. We change rider.
I'm sorry about that.
No, that's fine. But I said...
We only have one horse. But I was two riders.
But I was telling her, now when she's riding and warm up your horse, she's your trainer.
Yes, you're right. Yeah.
And her job is to make your horse good for your student.
Yes.
And not good for herself, but for your student.
That's what she says too. She's really like that. Absolutely.
Yes.
Yeah, absolutely
so,
right.
But
quicker for the leg, easier.
Right.
Yeah.
Because she has a lot of feeling and talent.
I think so too.
And she can be good.
Yes.
The right horse is the right training.
Yeah.
She has a good feeling.
I think
and,
so too. Yeah.
And
I
also,
really
what
like
I said, she really good in her.
Yes, and she wants to.
How old is she?
27.
Oh, she's...
Yeah. Oh. She's going to go to Denmark next week.
Oh, yeah?
For her birthday. Norway. I think her boyfriend is in Norway.
Okay.
He's American, but he lives there.
Yes.
I think.
Oh,
and
good.
Then she's going to spend a few days in Denmark.
I think she was a lot younger.
Yeah, she looks younger. Yes, she looks like a child. Which is good. I wish I looked like a child.
Right. Me too.
Can I give this to you? You know how this works.
Yeah, I know,
yeah. Yeah. You want to do it around
it's
your
really
neck?
High. You sure your horse not get afraid for it?
No, he's used to it.
Okay.
Yes. You want to have it higher, or are you okay?
No, it's okay. Now I have everything. I look like a man from the television.
I know you are. You can be make a lot of money. Start singing.
No, so yeah. Oh. So people running away if I start singing.
Yeah, me too.
Okay.
Right. Oh, I'll plug you in. Hook you up.
Good.
I'll hook you up.
Shall I run?
All right.
It's okay.
Now it's talking.
Hello?
Yeah.
Okay.
It works well.
Yeah.
I use it with everybody now. Outside in the wind, got to keep it high, not in front
okay.
of you. You can put it on your head. Wear it. As a,
this way.
A little crown. There you go. See?
Okay.
You see? Nice, huh?
Really nice.
Yeah, it is.
Did I look nice?
You have one.
I have one.
You don't use it.
No.
You have a loud voice. I don't.
No, okay.
I use it with everybody.
Yes.
And outside with the wind blowing.
Oh, yes, good. But yeah, I use your headset.
Oh, yeah, sure. Yeah. Yeah. Do you mind if I stay?
So no, it's okay.
She doesn't understand. I
no,
translate.
Yes, good. You don't understand English?
I tell her in Dutch. Between the Dutch and the Danish.
Right.
We'll figure it out.
No, but I have been really pleased with the horse. It worked fine here,
yeah.
And you know, I was telling her job when she riding is to make him good for you.
Right. Yeah.
You know, so yes. He get easy forward, nice in your hands. He like mm-hmm. to come down,
mm-hmm.
so get a good back to sit on,
right.
And light for your legs.
Yeah.
It's what yeah. is the basic things we want.
Right.
So we feel it's nice to sit on your horse, mm-hmm. or your horse work together with you, like to go,
mm-hmm.
but not running away.
Right.
So you have a thing on, you have control.
Sounds good to me.
Yep. And you know, it is to control your tempo, so he mm-hmm. forward, but not running.
Right.
And you can get his neck down,
mm-hmm.
You know, so your back get nice to sit on, and then your shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
I feel like here, your hardest part was your shoulders.
Mm-hmm.
Right. It's the most difficult to control his shoulders,
mm-hmm.
because when you so like bending, so he bend your neck and drop your opposite
mm-hmm.
shoulder.
Mm-hmm.
And yes, it's important to not make more bending and you control your opposite side.
Yeah.
So your more bending you have, your more you have to have focus on your opposite side. Yeah. So you not try to fix one thing but lose your other.
Yeah.
So, but you just take your time for walking forward and feel how he is now. Okay. Okay.
Maybe, I don't know.
Good. So you just walk him forward, so you can get your contact to his mount. So just feel his mount. So yes. Oh, good. So you try to shorten your reins a little, so you have contact. Right. Good. And now, when you know your horse, we change the rider. So your horse have to feel, okay, now you see how she was riding.
Mm-hmm.
So you need to have this picture in your head,
mm-hmm.
because your horse will feel it still is the same rider as on. Your horse
that
was,
would be nice.
Yeah, but it's the way you start thinking.
Yeah.
If you have too big a difference, so of course your horse also changed, you know.
Yeah.
So yeah, you shall go after exactly the same things. Where you feel your mounts, open, close your fingers.
Mm-hmm.
And then, if your horse likes to go slower, you use your legs.
Mm-hmm.
So you end up, you have your contact between your legs and your reins,
mm-hmm.
so your horse gets connected.
Okay.
And this is what shall make it so you control your neck, mm-hmm. get your back up, so you get good to sit on.
Okay.
And don't be afraid to touch him. If you do it too much, I will tell you.
All right.
Yep. So yeah, and keep a little more contact to his mount. Good. Right. A little more contact so he get more round. So yeah, try to move, feel his mount. Good. And touch him a little more. You're too nice. Yep. Good. So yeah, just get contact. Right. Yep. So open and close your fingers, so you get more round, a little more down. Yep, so yeah. So you also get control over his neck. Eat what he needs. Good. So you come down into your bridle. So yeah. You have to feel your horse like to coming down. So you don't like to get up, but down into your bridle to get contact. Okay, good. You just go trot again. And keep this feeling. Yep. Good. Right. So you open and close your fingers a little bit. So yeah, first you work on to get him more round. Yep. So yeah, good. It's from here you shall start your training. Okay. Just now it's better he go too low than it is he get too high. Because if you get too high, it's hard to sit. Yep. Just make your circle a little bigger. So you can get him a little more forward. Right. So yeah. So it's from forward you get him more down. Good. Try, yeah, so push a little for your legs so you keep attention. Good. Alright. Let him change the range and go over to right. And see if you can bring him more forward. So you keep your hands a little out to your side and then feel his mount, yeah. So you stay, when you have your contact, you stay very elastic. Right. Good, and get forward. Good, and try turning again, yeah. So when you take on the range, you take a little to your side and see if you can keep him in front of your legs. Good, yep. Okay, good. When he's just there, you relax your hand. Okay, you just relax your hands when he come down and then you push forward. And you feel it's all what you need to do just now to get him down into